It has been a very interesting first half of play. Virginia leading Florida State 17-14. The Seminoles jumped out to a 7-0 lead when Warrick Dunn burst 65 yards for a touchdown. Brilliant run here. You gotta have good vision to pull something like that off. He found his way. But not much time elapsed until Tiki Barber, the great running back for Virginia, answered with this 48-yard run around the corner to tie the score at 7.
Seems like he saves his best games against Florida State.
Then Pat Busby threw to Messam 48 yards for a touchdown as he scrambled for some room, and it worked to make it 14-7 Seminoles. And then Busby fumbled after being sacked by Travis Griffin.
Defense again sets the tone for UVA.
They had the ball at the Florida State 6-yard line, and then Aaron Brooks went over the top on a quarterback sneak to make it 14-14, a 38-yard field goal, untied it, and the Cavaliers will start the second half of play, leading 17-14 in front of a homecoming crowd at Florida State of 80,237, the second largest crowd in FSU history. A line drive to the goal line, picked up by Terrence Wilkins, looking for the wedge, bounces outside, taken down at the 17. Now Lynn Swan.
Thank you, Keith. I talked to George Walsh when he went in. He said that Tim Sermon just needed to settle down, and the offense had to pick up first downs. He said, we can't sustain this level of play on defense. What we've got to do is make first downs to keep our defense off the field. On the other side, Bobby Bowden said Warrick Dunn had his ankle wrapped. He's going to try it in the second half. Said the QB is playing well, but he needs his quarterback, you know, just to be able to dump the ball off when he's in trouble. Keith?
All right, here we come with Virginia owning the football to start the second half of play. As Sherman steps up and throws quickly, and he threw a knuckleball, but it's complete to Demetrius Dotson. I would start this second half of play, Bob Greasy, with this note. Bobby Bowden has never lost a homecoming game.
Look at this. Turnovers for Florida State. They've had two turnovers, and UVA converted one of those into 7 points. Look at the starting average starting field position. UVA on their own 46, the 19-yard line for Florida State. That is a huge difference.
Second down and one. Second effort may have gotten the first down. Maybe.
Did the ball come out?
I couldn't tell whether the ball came out or not. He lunged ahead.
Yes, it did. It was flying around.
And
Tiki Barber again got it.
Yep. Medley was there.
Medley, the fullback, is usually a blocking back at Spain, I think, that knocks it loose. It's kicked around.
Yeah, there's the ball. Somebody kicked it.
And there is Tiki right at it.
So his alertness again. That's the second time now he saved the ball today. And on the first down play, they pitch it. He steps on somebody's foot and trips as he gets out to the 30. The first half possessions look like this.
And they did pretty well when they got good field position. About the fourth down, they said own 48. They took two plays and got a touchdown. And then the opponent's 6-yard line, they took it in on two plays for a touchdown. That's just field position has been big time key in this ball game.
Second down and 7. Virginia. Sherman with time, and now runs out of it. Get a couple of yards.
Tim Sherman on the keeper.
Here's a look at the first half stats. Sherman was 2 of 11. 34 yards, nothing there. 112 yards for Barber in that big touchdown run. And Crowell, 2 receptions, led the receivers.
All out near the 32, where it is 3rd down and 6.
Crockett led the tacklers for the Seminoles.
Those go to dime package defensively. Virginia in shotgun with 3 wide. Nobody to throw it to now. By Samari Roll. There was nobody available. Sherman tried to force it in between defenders and paid the price.
First of all, Sherman's got good protection. Nobody. Now he panics. He's got good protection. He sees somebody, but he doesn't see the whole field. He saw his receiver, but he didn't find the defensive backs, and Roll came back with the pick.
Opportunity coming up for Florida State.
I heard someone say, what will they think of next? And I thought, how wonderful it is to imagine that someone is out there thinking of things. And that's their job, to think of something that no one has ever thought of. And all we have to do is wait and wonder, what will they think of next?
The Chrysler Cirrus, Concorde, and LHS, bringing what's next from the cab-forward engineering of Chrysler.
Their goals are as basic as a first home, an education, a secure retirement. Yet they own over half of all the stock in America. They are individual investors, and for them, nothing is more valuable than information. Today, NASDAQ is delivering news about companies, performance tracking, even timely stock quotes, instantly. So if you're an investor who seeks vital information, you now know where to find it.
Katerina Gordieva and Rudy Galindo make their pro singles debut in the first ever U.S. Pro Figure Skating Championships, Halloween night on ABC.
Here's the interception. This is Roll right here. Now, let's go ahead and roll it. He's going to try and throw to the receiver. Now, let's stop it right here. Now, there's nobody open. There's a receiver here. There is a receiver here. There's nothing in the middle of the field. Watch to the bottom of the screen. He's going to scramble. Now, the receiver breaks inside, and Roll comes back and makes a good play.
And it's a first down for Florida State at the 42-yard line with Warrick Dunn. Tate Bankel and all out on the field. Busby, play action, throws it down the middle. Pass is caught by Melvin Pearsall, the tight end. The Virginia quarterbacks this season have been intercepted 10 times. Sherman 7 and Brooks 3.
And they only have 4 touchdown passes, so 4 touchdowns, 10 interceptions.
The gain is down to the 36-yard line. It'll be second down at about 4. Get behind the line of scrimmage, he'll lose a yard. He didn't look all that nimble either.
Here's a look at the possessions for Florida State. They scored on their fourth and fifth possession. And then nothing after that. Had 9 possessions in the first half.
And it's third down and 5 now for the Seminoles. It's still an offense looking for an identity. Defense on both teams been terrific. The offense is struggling a bit.
You have to give credit to the defense for Virginia. 8 tackles behind the line.
Right. Getting good penetration. Busby rolls it out. Throws complete to the 22-yard line. Wayne Messam. Wayne Messam has been a story coming into this ball game because his coaches said it was incredible that he could drop as many balls as he had dropped. He dropped them in practice. He dropped them on the way to the bed. He dropped them on the way to the breakfast table. And now all of a sudden today, the ball is sticking.
Well, he's inconsistent at best, and that is true, Keith. Let's take a look at the offensive leaders in the first half. Busby was 14 of 23, a touchdown and interception. Dunn had 109 yards and a pretty good distribution as far as the receivers.
First down at the Virginia 21-yard line.
Here it comes.
Busby gets it away into the end zone. Man is wide open. It is touchdown, E.G. Green.
Thank you.
from Aurora, Colorado for the extra point.
Mudrick, after the first down, first play, going to the pass. E.G. Green beats Phelan, number 49, to the back end of the end zone. Makes the catch, the foot is down.
And it's 21-17, Florida State.
Together we are better than we could ever be alone. We'll be a team forever. The world is ours to own. You're a part of me. That's the heart of me. Dr. Pepper, you're a part of me.
Australia's Great Barrier Reef. You don't need fins to swim under it. You don't need wings to fly over it. You don't need four legs to run through it. But you just might need to bring this. Because Reef Watch Air Tours, Wild Track Jeep Safaris, and Pro Sail Scooters will take you on the ride of your life. But they won't take American Express. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
What happens when you don't just make something? You invent something.
The Chrysler Cirrus LXI. Now receive $1,000 cash back. The Chrysler Cirrus. The difference between just making something and inventing something.
Football on ABC Sports is brought to you by Chrysler, exploring the new frontiers of automotive technology. What's new in your world? And Burger King, where you can get your burgers worth. Well, let's see now if the Virginia offense can do something. If they don't do anything to speak of and the defense has to hustle back out, that last play could be a wheel breaker.
Florida State scoring after the turnover by UVA.
10:37 to go in the third quarter. Goes to the lead, 21-17. Bentley's kick going well into the end zone and will not be returned by Joe Rowe. So the Cavaliers will come out and begin this possession at the 20. And next Saturday, oh, we've got some old-fashioned down-home head knockers. Nebraska, Oklahoma, Michigan State, and Michigan. That'll get you cranked up and going. And then these. Northwestern, which shook the sack and another miracle came out today, will be at Penn State. Washington at USC. Maryland at Clemson and Baylor at Texas. Check your ABC station or your cable operator to see what he might have available. Kim Sherman is the quarterback for Virginia. Hands the ball to Tiki Barber. Barber is hit, solid tackle by Shevin Smith, the strong safety. Yard on the play.
Shevin Smith is an interesting story, Keith. He was a walk-on initially at Florida State. He earned a scholarship in August, and it was a scholarship that was a Perry Moss, the wide receiver.
Right.
When he left school, he took that scholarship and gave it to Shevin Smith. He's had two touchdowns this year, one on an interception, one on a fumble recovery.
Broken face mask has to come off. Back goes Sherman. Pressure coming. He's down. Boulware. Peter Boulware, the junior out of Columbia, South Carolina. Loss is back to about the 15-yard line.
Here's a look at the Seminole defense the first five games, and then today, Boulware was blocked by two different men, the left tackle and then the offensive back. This is his second sack of the day. That's the one back, Medley, and then the other back. I don't care how many backs you have, you'll not block Boulware with two backs.
Third and 15. They send Barber to the 17, and they will punt it after Henry Crockett makes the tackle. So they turn it over. The Seminoles stick at the end zone. The defense stifles them. Now they need a big kick from Will Bryce. The last time they had to have one, he gave him a 60-yarder.
Well, this Will Bryce has been the best weapon for the Virginia offense all day. Aside from the run by Tiki Barber.
Well, he didn't get all of it. D. Feaster calls a fair catch up at the 45-yard line. And so the Seminoles have good field position to start the second possession of the second half. 38 yards on that punt. Shadows now pretty much cover the entire playing surface.
Florida State getting the best of the field position in the second half. Virginia having only five first downs in the first half, and they have yet to make a first down here in the second half.
Warrick Dunn is out there again, so the ankle apparently is all right. Poobar Williams, the fullback. Busby sets him up. And that goes to Warrick Dunn. And Dunn will get it to midfield. That's about a 5-yard gain. Stephen Phelan and Rondé Barber made the tackle.
I don't know if he's right from that ankle, Keith. He moved pretty good, but I think when he wanted to make a final cut, I'm not sure that the ankle was going to be there.
In the previous possession, when he carried it and he tried to make a cut, he looked pretty tender. You're right. You got Cooper and Green now coming to the bottom of the picture as the wideouts. Double dose of poison there. Here's the ball thrown underneath to Warrick Dunn. And he'll go down to the 40-yard line of Virginia for a first down.
I take that back. I think Warrick's all right. There's a look at Dunn, the tailback. Play action, he just wants to... He looks downfield. This is just like a long handoff. Get it to him. That's not a real good pass. You want to get it up high where he can catch it and keep moving on it. He had to make an effort to stop and catch it.
7.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Busby out of the shotgun. And about the only way that Jamie Sharper was going to get Poobar down was to take his legs away, and he went right for the ankles and he got him.
Well, he's a fullback that weighs 285 pounds that can catch and is pretty nimble.
Rolling the other way. And look out, but he made the catch. Ron Dugans made the catch, and he got away from Rondé Barber. Barber almost got a hand on it.
Mark Richt is calling the plays for Busby, and he's calling a lot of pass plays because that's what's getting him the yardage.
Ball is put on the 20-yard line as the chain gang finally catches up. Short of win, but they're there. First down.
Virginia has lived with their defense the last couple of years, especially this year, and they're looking for him to make a play here.
Covered it. It'll come out to the 20-yard line. Oh, that's not just a bullet. That's a howitzer.
Well, that's why Pooh Bear has not been playing at fullback, because he's been overweight, out of shape. Look at him here. He gets hit once. He spins. That boy didn't even get hit. That ball just comes out too easily. And Virginia, again, the defense, creates something and stops the other team's offense.
Save the day.
That ball just comes out too easily. Rondé Barber.
And the defense now getting the big roar from the crowd. Thomas Jones is in at tailback for UVA, a freshman from Appalachia. He's getting his first playing time of the day at tailback. And we've got 6.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. 21-17 Noles.
Jones is a true freshman, number 6, Keith. You can't throw the ball. You're having problems with your pass protection. Your quarterback is not throwing it well. You've got to go in your running game, and that's being stifled.
Sherman's pass to Crowell is good.
Or as Mr. Greasy says, Crowell.
Tomorrow, don't miss final round coverage of the Tour Championship. Ooh, have you not heard what Tom Lehman is doing to Southern Hills? My goodness. 13 under par. Leading, obviously. That's tomorrow at 3 Eastern time here on ABC Sports. Those of you who have never traveled about Southern Hills, ladies and gentlemen, 13 under par in 3 rounds is phenomenal. Sherman's pass. Play down across the 40 all the way to the Florida State 38, and the crowd of 80,000 plus gets a little quieter.
That's a completion.
Little play action, the fake to the left, the tight end lined up on the left and went across the field to the right. This is by far the best pass play for Virginia today.
Tight ends, I'm telling you, they're the secret weapon. Those are tight ends. That ball's almost intercepted again by Samari Roll. He was intended for the wide receiver on that side, but it was Roll who got his hands on it. Looks like Samari wants that job back, doesn't it? Alabama's lead is 7 now over Tennessee, 13-6 in the third quarter.
Alabama's kind of owned Tennessee lately, haven't they?
Except for last year.
Yeah, right.
They got a pretty good woodshed in last year.
Yeah, but before that. Yep.
On second down, passes away, and it is way, way overthrown. The receiver, Crowell, got out there. Made a turn back into the ball, and by then it was gone.
Yeah, they're not even close. Crowell went down and broke to the outside, and Sherman threw the ball way upfield. This was a little stop and go. Sherman, 1 of 10 the first half, is now 3 of 6, 47 yards and an interception, which led to a Florida State touchdown.
Tiki Barber has come back now at the tailback position. Harold Medley, the fullback.
Hubert Williams had that fumble
into the end zone and fumbled it away. Third and 10 here. Number 79, Doug Kurzewski, was moving before the snap on the Virginia offensive line.
Well, he's blocking on either Boulware or Wilson, those two defensive ends.
There's Boulware up there on the town on that side right now, anyway. It'll do that to you after
you've
watched him go by two or three times.
Boulware has 2 sacks today and 12 on the season. The record is 12 by Ron Simmons. Actually, has 11 and a half. But how do you get a half a sack? I always give him the other one.
Got him. It's Peter Boulware.
That's his 3rd sack for the afternoon. Now he has the record. He's got, officially, he's got 12 and a half sacks on the season.
But Bernard Wilson had 28 coming into the game, so he was the first to go past Ron Simmons' record.
Wilson has the career. Boulware now has set a record for the season.
Will Bryce. Oh, the punt. Oh, not a very good snap. His own man was shoved back in front of him, but he got it off. And out of bounds at the 4-yard line. That works out all right. For the Cavaliers at 4:50 to go in the third quarter. And Florida State leading by 4.
I heard someone say, what will they think of next? And I thought, how wonderful it is to imagine that someone is out there thinking of things. And that's their job, to think of something that no one has ever thought of. And all we have to do is wait and wonder, what will they think of next?
The Chrysler Cirrus, Concord, and LHS. Bringing what's next from the cab-forward engineering of Chrysler.
lots of reasons to buy life insurance. Here are two great ones. I'm State Farm agent Mike Foy. As the Goff family has grown, so have their life insurance needs. That's why we get together for family insurance checkups. I make sure to explain all the options, then they decide on the plan that's right for them. Ask your State Farm agent for a family insurance checkup. It's a great way to learn about life.
In an age of streamlining and downsizing, Chili's still makes its Big Mouth burgers by hand, one at a time, by a person. What this lacks in efficiency is more than made up for in taste. Chili's Big Mouth burgers, monuments of inefficiency.
Play football at Chili's this season. In every restaurant, you can win two round-trip tickets on Southwest Airlines to anywhere they fly, a football or Chili's Big Mouth burgers, all just for playing.
On the campus of Florida State is the National High Magnetic Field Laboratory, largest of its kind in the world. Magnets here can help elucidate the molecular structure of proteins that may one day lead to the discovery of new medicinal drugs.
What the heck you know about all that stuff, Len?
Swanee, could I bring the magnet I use for my lower back and get it recharged?
Well, you could probably get it recharged, but when you walk in the building, you have to be careful, Keith. They search you to make sure you don't have metal. So you're not sucked into one of those giant magnets.
Ooh, uh-huh. I'd lose both my knees. All right, here we go with the ball back on the four-yard line. They're just trying to wedge it out a bit and get a little working room. It's Busby.
That's the old
squeezes a couple of 3 yards.
That's the old wedge play.
Yep,
the old quarterback sneak in the wedge. Haven't run that since I was in grade school.
Did your center have hip pockets that you could grab on and hang on to?
Oh, the bigger the better. The bigger the better. Felt comfortable. There's Busby, 6 out of 6 in the second half. He's come out hot. But again, Bryce has backed them up inside their 5-yard line to start this drive.
Handed up front to the fullback. Breaks it out across the 25-yard line for the first down. A sophomore from Davie, and he comes out dragging a leg. Looks like that might be in the neighborhood of a hamstring.
Well, both times they've run the fullback, the last two times, this one with Abdullah and then the previous one with Pooh Bear Williams where he fumbled, the fullback up the middle has been there.
That means Pooh Bear's back. Did they check him for stickle?
Just don't give him the ball.
Well, Donald have a yard on that one. It'll be second down and 9. 21-17, Florida State. Virginia beleaguered here in the third quarter. Florida State losing another touchdown in the end zone when Williams fumbled the ball away. Ron DeBarber recovered it.
Well, it hasn't been pretty all year for George Welsh's offense. They've been struggling. They lost 3 offensive linemen, their 2 wide receivers, and their quarterback.
Here comes Pooh Bear. He's got it. And he's out to the 31.
Number 22, Pooh Bear Williams on the carry.
He is junior from Crescent City. And he has a terrible time in his weight down.
Bobby was saying yesterday, he says he's a good kid. He says he just loves to eat. He says he's like me. And Bobby grabs his stomach. He says, it's like me. He says, I like to eat too. He says, but I don't have to play.
I saw you putting away that sawmill gravy.
Hey, I didn't touch that sawmill gravy.
Putting it away. Put it in a box so you could pick it, would you? Third down. Pass. Bullet complete to Messam. So Wayne Messam has had a big day. Out to the 40-yard line and the first down, 41-yard line. He is a fifth-year senior from South Bay, Florida. I think George now is realizing that if something doesn't happen good for his offense, that his defense is just simply going to wear out.
Yeah.
And it will. You can't play. Defense can't play.
Well, you have to be patient.
45 minutes.
You know, and he's what he's doing is forcing Florida State to go the whole length of the field.
That pass is well underthrown.
when you back Florida State up with a great punter like Bryce inside their five-yard line, they may make some plays, they may make some yardage, but if they take 14 or 15 plays to get all the way down the field, you think if your defense is pretty good, which Georgia's is, they'll stop them somewhere along the way. When you start from your own end zone, it's a long haul. Busby, now that's the first incompletion of this half. We told Bobby yesterday he ought to get a jacket tie on, look like an executive down there.
Yeah, so I told him I'd go buy him a vest. Second down and 10. This is Dunn. And he does not have the quickness now with that sore ankle to bounce outside as he might well have done if he were total. And so he doesn't get much out of that play. A couple of yards. Make it three and make it third down and 7 now.
Total yardage on the right side. Florida State has doubled that of Virginia.
Buzzing, good protection. Andre Cooper. It's a big one all the way to the 34-yard line.
Very rarely do you ever see just a two-man route by Florida State. And the reason you do this is because of pass protection problems. You drop back only the two wide receivers. He's going to throw to the one down on the right side. He comes in, runs a post corner in between the two defensive backs, and that's a good route and a throw.
And first down, Knowles, Virginia, 34. Busby back. He's looking for Green. Flag at the line of scrimmage. Thrown by the umpire. Almost certain to be holding.
That's a killer. That's a killer.
That's two touchdowns now the Seminoles have lost in that end zone in the third quarter. One on Williams' fumble, and now the holding to nullify that one.
You say it was a face mask on the offense?
Face mask on the offense, yeah. Same as holding. Somebody grabbed it and held on.
Face mask by the offense on the blocking. 15 yards, repeat the down.
Right side of the screen. I don't know. Couldn't see it. But what it, bottom line is, the most penalized team in the ACC is Florida State, and that one takes away a touchdown. They came in averaging 80 yards in penalties per game.
First and 25 now as Busby throws the ball to Cooper. And Cooper is at the 35. Almost where the possession started before the penalties. So they'll be looking second and about 10. The tomahawk chop. They didn't used to do that here. They had the song and all that, didn't they? But that, wasn't that tomahawk chop something relatively new recently? Going to have three.
I don't know, Keith, about that chop. I know the Braves do it up in Atlanta.
And I know that some.
I don't know whether it started here at FSU first or whether it was in Atlanta first.
Pretty good football game out in Boulder as the Buffaloes have come back to lead 21-17. Yet started here. Oh, yeah. Oh, yes. Long time ago. But. They complained loudly about it when Drake started using it. That pass is completed to Andre Cooper.
And his legs are taking him on. He goes down hard, but he holds on down at the 23-yard line. Rondé Barber hit him. And so, that should be a first down at the end of the third quarter.
It's country driving. It's fancy coat and tie. Ooh, it's the football team. Your beauty queen. It's why we're right nearby. And best of all, it's thrifty. Renting cars in your neighborhood. Ooh, best of all, it's thrifty. Coming through like you knew we would.
If we all settled for good enough, would things ever be good enough?
The luxurious Chrysler LHS. Now get a lease for just $359 a month. The Chrysler LHS. This goes way beyond good enough.
Coming to ABC 1 week from Sunday. Now that more of you are investing, remember, it isn't who you know, it's who knows you. This is the South Florida Water Management District. Non-elected bureaucrats who'll spend the $1 billion raised by Amendment 4. The South Florida Water Management District has earned a reputation for wasting money. Florida Tax Watch criticized their lax oversight with taxpayers' money. Over $1 million in unauthorized bonuses, private planes for board members, another $1 million in missing materials. Vote no on Amendment 4. It's just another $1 billion for the bureaucrats.
News Channel 27 is ABC.
We go now to the final quarter of play. Thad Busby stepped up in that third quarter, didn't he? 25 out of 35 now for 316 yards. That is a career high for him. He has a couple of interceptions and he has a touchdown.
This may be the hump.
Or the way around.
Yeah. This may be the hump game for Thad Busby. Yep. Keith, the other two strong defenses that they played, one was North Carolina. And there was another tough one, and he didn't do well against the tough ones.
Clemson started to break out, and the offense rolled against Miami pretty well. This is Abdullah carrying. Khalid Abdullah back in at fullback, and on first down, he picks up about 3 yards. But when Bobby took the headset off and told Mark to go ahead and call the plays, things have accelerated some.
Yeah. Score here after three quarters, and the numbers, big total yardage in favor of FSU. Turnovers, both teams have gotten 7 points off of them. And Florida State with those penalties, which took away a touchdown. Let's look at Mark Richt on the left, the offensive coordinator for the Seminoles.
21-17, Florida State leading. This is Warrick Dunn, takes a couple of hard hits at about the line of scrimmage and winds up with a yard or so.
The Seminoles.
Go ahead.
I was just going to say, the Seminoles had 20 more plays through the first three quarters and had the ball 8 minutes more than the Cavaliers did.
And right now, at this point of the ball game, you have to feel, leading by 4 on the scoreboard, another touchdown would make it 11 points.
Well, that's
a lot.
That's a lot for a UVA offense.
Yep.
It's not real potent.
Yep. 14th play of the drive coming up right here. The first down. give you some indication right there that the Virginia defenders are getting tired. Busby ran by two of them. I mean, literally ran by them.
Now, well, there's number nine, Taylor, the middle linebacker.
He's one of them.
Only two men are out, and when you have only two guys out, you're not going to have many choices. The difference in this year's game for Florida State than last year's is that Danny Cannell last year would not scramble downfield. Busby will this year. He'll run.
Hand off to the fullback, the up man out of the I formation. And the ball moves inside the eight. Abdullah. It looked like he might have hurt a hamstring. He's now stepping up. Number 51 getting up rather slowly there is Kevin Long, the center.
He's had a bad knee, number 51. Well, you see that knee brace that he wears. A lot of the offensive linemen will wear just a standard knee brace, and that looks like it's a little bit more than just a standard one. Yep.
Number 89, Wayne Messam. A 6'4 wide receiver is on the field now. He's at the top of the picture with Cooper. Into the middle, and we'll move the ball to about the 6-yard line. So we'll be looking at third down. It looks as if it is possible for them to get a first down without scoring, but it would be close.
Yeah. Well, this is what I mentioned earlier. Rick Lance, the defensive coordinator for George Welles's Cavaliers, this is what he wanted. Make them take a lot of plays to move it down. This drive started on the 4-yard line. What do they got? What is it? 17th play of the drive.
Same alignment. Whistle stop them.
E.G. Green calling timeout. He saw they didn't have enough time to run that play.
They were down to one tick, and he got it just in time with 11:42 to play in the game.
I could be like a rock. Nothing ever got to me.
At the end of the day, there's only one full-size pickup that's best in initial quality.
Like a rock.
Chevy CK. It's a dirty job, but somebody's got to do it.
Like a rock.
Some of the most admired cars you'll see are owned by the guys who know cars best. They're ASC certified master mechanics, and the number one brand of motor oil these guys use in their own cars and trucks is Valvoline, makers of DuraBlend, the leading semi-synthetic for a cleaner engine due to better control of harmful deposits. So use the oil the mechanics who take care of your car use to take care of theirs. Valvoline. People who know use Valvoline.
You will be called private, specialist, or sergeant. Beneath the ribbons on your chest will be the souls of those who came before. You will be an individual, but triumph as a team. You will know strength, courage, and compassion. You will win what must be won, achieve what must be done.
Be all that you can be.
You will be a soldier.
It's a key Big Ten battle when Penn State hosts Northwestern, or regional action from the Pac-10, Big 12, and ACC on an ABC college football doubleheader next Saturday.
These kind of numbers can win you a football game if you have the lead late. It also means that you're playing pretty well to have run 16 plays over that distance and not have made a mistake.
And like we said earlier, to go out and win it, just don't lose it. You got a lot of help, and he's playing a very smart game. This may be a game that gets him over the hump.
He's 11 of 12 for 131 yards and a touchdown, looking for his second, and he put the ball right on the hands of Khalid Abdullah, and he dropped it.
It's good defense. Down there inside, you're going to play a lot of tight coverage. Abdullah could have caught that pass. He only came in only two receptions on the year, Abdullah, so that's not who you wanted to throw it to, but he was the outlet.
It's Scott Bentley is on for the field goal try now. His career long is 48. Distance is not the factor here. The mark, they got a Florida State man shaken up on the play and down on the field. That's Andre Cooper, and they're working on that right leg. But Bentley became part of, when he first came here, he became part of the wide right story in the famous games against Miami.
Yeah. That's been a long time ago, 4 years. Yeah. He's done a lot of weightlifting, got a lot stronger. He's got a lot more confidence this year, Bentley.
Georgia Tech, which had a close one today against Central Florida. Look at that. I think they must have had a nap. But they beat Virginia in Atlanta, and that's where Florida State's going next week.
They may be looking forward to next week, Keith, thinking that they didn't have a problem with Central Florida.
Yep. North Carolina better look out tonight in Houston, too. I'm telling you, two or three people have told me that have played Houston this year say that they're no bargain. They're tough. Time still out for the injured player. Now he's up.
Cooper has seven receptions on the day for 102 yards. Last year he caught 71 passes for over 1,000 yards and 15 touchdowns.
This will be a 25-yard field goal try.
Only one out there. And here it comes. The only compact pickup to offer a third door. Okay, folks. Show's over. Chevy S10, like a rock.
For the very best in home entertainment, the place to go is Circuit City, where right now this RCA digital satellite system is just $199.97 after $200 cash back from DirecTV. Just sign up for 1 year of DirecTV's Total Choice programming, and the RCA DSS system is yours for only $199.97. Get more movies, more sports, more news, more channels than cable. Plus, get coupons worth over $200 from USSB when you buy any DSS system. Hurry into Circuit City today.
Time now for the Burger King College Football Play of the Day. Hershel Troutman takes the pitch. Looks like he wants to pass. Then a little spin move there and takes off 13 yards for the touchdown. 21-17. We told you Coy Detmer was out of the game. He did not return. A concussion, the problem. 21-17. Keith.
So Detmer.
Look at John Hessler. He played all of last year and did very well.
John's going to become known as the Miracle Man.
Yeah.
All right, Bentley will kick it off from the 35-yard line. Terrence Wilkins and Joe Rowe are deep for Virginia.
See if they kick it deep to him. They've run the three kickoffs back for touchdowns this year.
Yes, he knocked it as far as he could.
It's maybe their best offensive chance right here.
2 yards deep. Recovered by Virginia at the 13-yard line. Joe Rowe jumped on it. Or somebody. Joe Rowe returned it.
Yeah, and who was it? 52.
Somebody trailing the play. Got it.
It'd be Elegbe.
Wale Elegbe. Just stripped it right out of Rowe's hands. And almost 52 knocked it loose.
Right there.
Rowe and Elegbe.
Rowe has two touchdowns on the year on returns.
To about the 15-yard line for a couple of yards on the carry.
Stop is made by number 24.
Tiki Barber has been pretty quiet in the second half. Tomorrow night on ABC, an hour of America's funniest home videos, followed by an all-new Lois and Clark, and then Harrison Ford stars in Tom Clancy's Patriot Games, all tomorrow night on ABC. Six got a piece of him when it went by. Connell Spain, the big tackle.
Spain is the emotional leader of this defense. You see, he's patting the official. He fires everybody up.
Senior from Melbourne, Florida.
If you think those plays were kind of uninteresting as far as UVA are concerned, really they're not. They're giving it to the guy that can make the play for him, and that's Tiki Barber.
Crowd roaring for their defense. The pass is completed. It's close to a first down. Demetrius Dotson caught it. Depends on the spot.
Just a three-step drop and quick passing. They've been rushed all afternoon. Four sacks on the day. Just want to run a slant and a quick pass, and before that rush gets to you,
it's a first down.
You got to go back and give it to Tiki Barber. Either quick passing or give it to Tiki Barber. Maybe on a little swing. Get him out in the open field a little bit if you can.
7-point lead for Florida State, 24-17. Ball is at the 23 of Virginia. First down. Barber going outside. Ball coming back this way, and there's nobody over here. Now tired legs cave in. Mario Edwards.
He was the only right man. Exactly. Edwards was the only one left back on this side of the field.
So Barber makes the play and gives Virginia a first down at the 46.
Tiki Barber is the hope. 20 carries, 143 yards. And he has done something to this Florida State defense that no other runner has been able to do. And that is rushed for 100 yards three straight years against him.
Peter Boulware is off the field defensively for Florida State, having leg cramp troubles. And Lynn Swan told us that that's what was bothering Abdullah, the fullback. Thomas Jones is in the backfield now for Virginia. Kim Sherman back throwing, going deep. Look out, could be picked off. Almost picked off. The guy that kept him from Dexter Jackson from intercepting the ball was the intended receiver, Brian Owen.
Exactly. Trying to go deep. Sherman throwing on first down. One receiver going down. He's really not open because number 11, Jackson, who was a high school quarterback, switched the defensive back, should have caught it. But Owen does a nice job of breaking it up. Mickey Andrews is really high on Jackson. He thinks he's going to be the next great DB around here.
Second down and 10. Sherman. He wanted to pitch the ball, but the Florida State defender stepped between him and the...
I would have pitched it.
There's a gamble.
Oh, if you got Barber back there, you pitch it.
I thought the guy was right between him, and you might lose it. Alabama-Tennessee is tied now, so they got a pretty good war up there in the foothills today. And Texas has come back to lead Colorado 24-21. Ball is right on midfield, where it is third and 7. Pass play.
There they come.
He threw it hard. Dotson caught it. But it's well short of the first down. And Sherman's laying there trying to sort things out and see whether or not his body will let him get up. And it may not, because he took a lick. It is about 3 yards short of a first down. And now, while we're waiting here for Mr. Sherman to get some air back in him, let's join John Saunders.
I got plenty of air in me, Keith. Texas against Colorado, and Texas trying to steal one on the road. James Brown 2 yards to Matt Davis, and they regain the lead. It's now 24-21. Texas leads the Buffs. Keith.
That would be something of an upset, I'd say, especially in Boulder.
Well, there's no question that Texas is a good ball club. They just had some bumps along the way.
Well, Notre Dame broke their heart, and Virginia kicked them sideways.
Bowler gets a little bit of a late hit right there. Yeah, that'll knock the wind out of you.
Minutes and 15 seconds to play in the football game. Will Bryce is in the punt now. They need another big one from him. It's fourth down and at least four. They're saying five, maybe. They snap it up front to Medley, the fullback, and they eat him up. And the Seminoles get the football at the 47-yard line. They took a chance. Didn't care much for it either, because there's a lot of time to play in the football game. And now here's Florida State at their own 47.
Like a rock, I was strong as I could be. Like a rock, nothing ever got to me.
Chevy's got the highest resale value of any full-size pickup.
Like a
rock. Of course, to find that out, you'd have to sell it.
Like a rock.
Hey! Here's something I want you to think about. Discus.
Athletic.
Athletic. We're made for whatever you like to do.
Like biking.
Football.
And for you Europeans.
Football.
One brand for every sport.
You can't say that about these outfits.
My, the unitard.
That is special.
Unnecessary spending.
20 yards.
So, no matter what your game,
choose.
Discus Athletic.
One thing to wear.
But pick your colors carefully.
Lead car. Take it slow. Everybody okay? Wait a minute, what's he doing? He wants more. Right there.
I want
over there.
More and more. Oh, that got to be the flavor I've been looking for. Give me more.
Diet Dr. Pepper, the taste you've been looking for.
College football on ABC Sports brought to you by Chevrolet Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. Discus Athletic Active Wear. Discus Athletic, the one thing to wear for every sport. By Circuit City, the choice for price, selection, and service. And Chili's Grill and Bar, home of the Big Mouth Burgers.
Well, Florida State was not cool on that last punt formation. Little trickery.
Shotgun, low snap, giving a lot of pressure, trying to get around the corner, and the Cavaliers' pursuit gets him 2 yards at the most.
There's a look. I think this is what was George was upset about. There's a three linebackers. When they're lined up like that, you call it off. You want, when you call it, when you want it, is everybody's up here in these gaps and they're coming. But when you see the linebackers standing up like that, you call the fake punt off and you go ahead and punt it.
Who calls it off?
The fullback, the upback, somebody calls it off, either the punter or somebody. But George is saying they weren't even rushing. You should have called it off.
Well, it's second down and nine right here for the Seminoles as they go back to the conventional line formation and give it to Abdullah, the fullback. And he's very close to a first down as he burst it over the left side. Virginia defense now very obviously tired.
I think you're exactly right, Keith. What we said early on for Florida State, Busby, you don't have to win it, just don't lose it. He's had an outstanding day. And the nation's top, second defense against Barber, he has done pretty well. They have not stopped him, but they've overcome. One of the real stories in this game is the punting of Will Bryce. They've overcome that.
Check the chains for the first down. It's close, but not quite.
Said we needed a big day from the special teams. Well, Bryce has done that. He has put them back inside their own 20-yard line on several times, and they need takeaways. They got two fumble recoveries and an interception that led to 7 points, so they got three turnovers. They just didn't convert enough of them at this point. We got 7 minutes left in the ball game. The thing that has not been there is the UVA offense. They have not done much today. Tiki Barber, the one long run, and that's been it.
Bobby's going to be 67 next month. They're down at foot. And that's a first down on the quarterback sneak. Bob starts now on the spot of the ball at 6:32 to play in the ball game, and the Seminoles 24-17, and time permitting, 50 Carmel College Football postgame report. John and Todd will have the stories from around the country.
All the stories. Bobby has been the National Coach of the Year 4 different years. He's won a lot of ball games. In fact, he's the second winningest active coach behind Joe Pa up in Penn State.
He's getting on somebody's case a little bit here. Something going on that he didn't care for. On first down from the 43-yard line, there's Sweeper. It's Rock Preston. And look out. Oh, he may be headed for Hallelujah Land. Preston turned in a dazzling 42-yard touchdown run. He's liable to be the man next year. That tailback spot, he certainly will be one of them. Bentley for the extra point now. Play in the game. Florida State 31, Virginia 17.
There'll be a toss to that side. Kevin Long is down there. Watches all the Virginia players are over, going to run it. Poindexter, number 3. Look who's down there throwing the block now. The quarterback, Busby.
Yeah, but he went down there where the little guys were.
He found the little one. A long number.
Well, this concludes our tour of the Bud Light Brewery. Thank you very, very much.
Hey, look, everybody. It's a new guy.
Hey, new guy.
Hey, new guy. Name's Jim.
Been here since September 93. This here's Fred. He took the tour in 92.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down.
Welcome to paradise.
Make it a Bud Light.
You need anything from the outside, I'm the guy you see. Okay? Chips, pretzels.
In an age of streamlining and downsizing, Chili's still makes its Big Mouth burgers by hand, one at a time, by a person. What this lacks in efficiency is more than made up for in taste. Chili's Big Mouth burgers, monuments of inefficiency.
Play football at Chili's this season. In every restaurant, you can win 2 round-trip tickets on Southwest Airlines to anywhere they fly. A football or Chili's Big Mouth Burgers. All just for playing.
Chevy Blazer. The only sport utility vehicle with the driver control system. It's nice to know it's there.
Young person's life, they've got bridges to cross. Thad Busman may have crossed one of his today with a 25 for 36, 316 yard performance.
Peter Boulware led the charge for the Seminoles, three sacks, the number two defense in the country.
Messam took his game off the website, off the internet, and put it back on the football field where it belongs. He's had a great afternoon.
Kick is into the end zone. Comes back out to the 20 yard line. Had a bit of a scuffle on the field, and they separated, and no flags are thrown. So put it on the 20 for the Cavaliers, and they are right now at their last gasp. Tim Sherman comes out at quarterback. He gets it up around the 38-yard line for a first down.
Sherman is a fifth-year senior. He has sat for 4 years. He sat behind Grohl, who was the quarterback last year, and it was a battle between he and Brooks coming in. Virginia has had a history of playing fifth-year quarterbacks and doing well with them.
5:41 to play as Sherman steps up and throws and almost intercepted. Sean Key was almost in the end zone with that football before they could take a breath. Now here's 20.
Peter Boulware has been on the sidelines on first and second down situations. His legs cramped up here in the second half. The coaches have elected only to put him in on third down and use him in those situations. So it's now second down. But it's obvious passing situation, so he's back into the ball game, Keith.
Well, it was about, what was it, 85 degrees when we started today, wasn't it? So a lot of people have had trouble with cramps.
This would be a good time to play right now.
Yeah, it would. Barber pops it over the right side, and Tiki picks up seven. Clock running at 5:20 to play. Timeouts. Virginia has all three.
It's Raynard Wilson, the other end. He's all-time sack leader. They call him Big Country because his dad owns a farm.
A little quick pass is dropped. Demetrius Dotson couldn't get it.
Dotson, just a true freshman. They need some skill players, wide receivers.
Tonight, only on ESPN at 7 Eastern Time, Miami Hurricanes, who took a whipping last week from East Carolina, faces undefeated West Virginia. Don Nealon's ball club doing very well this year.
Yeah, aren't they?
Butch Davis fussing all week over the performance by his team last week against East Carolina. Tonight at 7 on ESPN. Will Bryce is in the punt now. He hammers that thing. They're going to kill it way down there. Whoa, almost bobbled it and almost rolled into the end zone, but they finally put it down at the one-yard line.
That kid could play for me anytime, that punter.
53 yards and no return, dead on the one.
Florida is idle. Nebraska is playing a little bit later on. Tennessee and Alabama are tied. Colorado's losing to Texas. Northwestern pulled another one out.
I presume Ohio State went ahead to win handily in Iowa.
Yep. Penn State won. They had a little trouble earlier with Indiana.
Yeah, they won. They scored 48 points.
Southern Mississippi's been up. Southern Mississippi is on the Florida State schedule. Where is that game played?
Here.
Played here. Okay.
Yeah, you're not going to go away.
Play Southern Mississippi.
You just don't do it. That's
Florida State has to go next week to Georgia Tech in Atlanta. That'll be, that won't be an easy one. They got Southern Miss, and then they got Florida here at the end of the year.
Warrick Dunn, Khalid Abdullah in the end zone, and Busby just takes it and tries to hang on to the big old lineman and ride it out for a couple of 3 yards. It's now 38-26, and they've got, there's a good bit of time remaining in that.
Iowa's really come back, haven't they?
Yes, they have. And Tennessee now has gone out on top of Alabama by 7. Knoxville.
Well, if Florida State takes care of business and Florida continues to roll, they'll be a pretty good ball game here Thanksgiving Saturday.
Sure.
In fact, I think last week in the off week, Florida State had some thoughts about Florida and some of the things they might have been doing, Keith. Working on their wide receivers and working on their defensive back coming up and bumping wide receivers. Working on the jam, getting away from the bump, and working on the bump. Those types of things, when you play good teams like Florida, you're going to have to be able to do.
Yeah, the corners will have a considerable burden on that particular Saturday, won't they? Indeed. Of course, the burden is lessened some if you're at Bulware and Wilson can get into the...
If you've got two defensive ends that can rush like Wilson and Bulware and a couple of corners that can cover for a short period of time, you don't have to cover from very long.
Be good to about the 8 yard line as Warrick Dunn tried to find some daylight and produce the big play. They had to get out past the 11 to get their first down. Time call by James Knight for the charge of timeout to Virginia. So they spend one of their three times out with 3:02 to play in the ball game.
There are lots of reasons to buy life insurance. Here are two great ones. I'm State Farm Agent Mike Foy. As the Goff family has grown, so have their life insurance needs. That's why we get together for family insurance checkups. I make sure to explain all the options, then they decide on the plan that's right for them. Ask your State Farm agent for a family insurance checkup. It's a great way to learn about life.
Chevy trucks, like a rock.
Send your package in 2 days with FedEx, and people are impressed. Cost, about $12.
Send your package in 2 days with UPS, and people are impressed. Cost, about $6.
Send your package in 2 to 3 days with Priority Mail from the U.S. Postal Service, and people are impressed. Cost, $3.
So, 12, 6, 3, what's your priority? Priority Mail from the U.S. Postal Service.
All right, here comes your punt. Out of the end zone.
Well,
by Sean Liss.
If Virginia can either block this, do some good, or run it back, which they've done this year, their special teams have been outstanding.
Tiki Barber is waiting just beyond midfield. They need a big one from Liss, and they get one. He delivered this time all the way back to the 40. And just barely covered it at the 42.
Ooh.
The Chevrolet most valuable players of the game for Virginia. Tiki Barber, running back, 21 carries, 150 yards, and one touchdown. Florida State, Thad Busby, 25 out of 36, 316 yards or maybe more before it's done. Chevrolet will donate $1,000 to each school's general scholarship fund to help outstanding students in their academic achievements and help those in financial need, a Chevrolet tradition for more than a quarter century.
It's been a tough year so far for Busby, but I think this one, they just put him over the top and...
Sherman hooks up with Froyle, and he gets past the corner and goes down the sidelines all the way down to the 23-yard line.
Cavaliers are saying, we're not out of this yet. Crowell just going to go down and run a little out down the sideline and then up. The defensive back on that side just...
He put on the
Yeah, he slipped. That's it. Was 15.
That's a big play. And you got a timeout, stopping the clock at 2 minutes and 49 seconds. Virginia's got two timeouts remaining. Florida State one now. And Virginia owns the football. First down, down around the 23-yard line of Florida State. Here's 20.
You know, this rivalry has really taken off between Virginia and Florida State. Virginia was the only team to beat Florida State, so they're going to commemorate it in the ACC. They're going to commemorate this rivalry with a new trophy, the Jefferson F. Trophy. And the first year, it goes to Virginia with that upset win for 1995. And that's Thomas Jefferson and Francis Epps. Epps was related to Jefferson and came down to Tallahassee and actually was an administrator at the original school that became Florida State. Keith?
All right. Those who don't know, and it's amazing how many don't know, it was Thomas Jefferson who founded, refined, defined, recruited the first faculty, served as the first rector, and was the man in charge when Virginia opened in 1825. And his idea was to produce a different kind of person. Most of the universities at that time were producing teachers and ministers, and it was the practical application to life that Jefferson wanted, and that's why he founded Virginia. First down, back goes Sherman. He throws it down the middle. The pass is caught. It is a touchdown for the Cavaliers.
Great throw and catch.
Boyle goes high in the air at 6'4 and hauls it down.
Florida State goes to a three-man line. They're dropping eight guys in the secondary. Crowell just goes straight up the field, is covered, but makes the play between two defensive backs. That's Jackson and Colsey. That's his sixth catch.
And Jackson is hurt. He took a knee into the rib cage. I saw that. He is shaken up. But it is the touchdown, and you've got 2 minutes and 43 seconds to play in the game. And it's now 31-23.
Going to come from the left side, top left of your screen, right down the middle of the field. That's a nice play by Crowell. He knew he was going to get hit, and he got into the end zone. Now the decision for George Welsh is, do I onside kick or do I kick it deep? Well, they have two timeouts left.
Yep. We went through a double overtime last week, so let us see what we shall see as Jackson comes off the field.
Keith and Bob, I wouldn't be surprised if you see Will Bryce come back out and punt. Remember, he punted after a touchdown in the first half, and the intent at that time was for him to pooch punt it, get it up in the air, let one of the up guys who would not be familiar catching a punt try and catch it, maybe create the turnover that way. So don't be surprised if Bryce is the guy who's kicking off after this extra point attempt.
You like him, Lenny? You think he should be a high draft choice in the NFL?
Bob, depending on what teams are playing on, what their needs are, if you can't fulfill a major need on your team, I'd make a guy like this a first-round pick.
No.
A great field position. Absolutely. Great guy was.
The extra point try by Garcia, the young man from Spain, native son of España, makes the extra point. It's a 7-point difference in the ball game. Let's worry about the NFL after we settle the issue here in college football.
Well, you can be sure that the guys on the other side of the field, there's a look at Bryce, the punter. You can be sure that the Florida State guys, thought they had this one wrapped up. And with that long pass completion to Crowell down the sideline and then the touchdown throw, this day game is still up for grabs.
So So we might he may be into the onside mode here because
this is
Whitney Majors is out there right now. He's a sophomore.
Well, this kid may be the specialist, the onside kick specialist right here.
Or he may be a sidewinding soccer kicker that can knock it out of town.
Not the way he's got that ball sitting.
No, you're right.
That ball is sitting for a bouncer. For a bouncer, that's right. Of course, Florida State's got all their good hands people out there.
2 minutes and 43 seconds and two timeouts remaining for the Cavaliers.
You don't have to put the ball on the tee. You can lean it against it just like that.
There it is. Here's your bounce right into the arms of a Seminole, E.G. Green. And he wraps his body around it.
You put all your receivers and your running backs, all the guys with the good hands out there. What you're hoping for is a huge hop right on the next bounce to go about 15 feet in the air, but you're not going to get it. Look at that. The Seminoles, three or four of them went up to block, and E.G. Green dropped back to fall on the ball. That's just good planning and execution by the Seminoles.
And the receiving team does not have to wait for the ball to travel 10 yards. You can go get it.
Yeah, you can.
So it's Seminole ball, first down at the Virginia 47.
Well, the Seminoles are going to have to make some first downs. Virginia has two timeouts left.
Warrick Dunn has the ball. And he's down to the near the 44, 43 maybe. Has regained the lead from Texas at 27-24, so it looks like John Hester is having another one of those days.
Yes, he is. Yep, he can play.
There's the faithful. 80,000.
Virginia.
237.
Virginia is used to these close games. They had 8 games that were decided by less than a touchdown last year. Last few minutes of the game.
Dunn right down on the 45-yard line. Poindexter and the Sherper on that hit.
We haven't heard much from Poindexter today.
He's been there, though, I'll tell you.
Sherper is 33 and Poindexter number 3.
A couple of times he put some knots on people. Like he takes a lot of room for a 6'1", 202-pound sophomore.
Yeah, Poindexter had 3 interceptions last week in their win. He's a linebacker who most of last year was shifted to free safety.
North Carolina gets out early over Houston down in Texas. Ball is right on the 45-yard line, third down and 8, a minute 52 seconds to play in the ball game. 7-point lead for Florida State on homecoming. The Virginia Cavaliers defensive people, the offense ought to hold the door for them all week.
Well, that's the makeup of this team, Keith. They've lost, like I mentioned, 3 offensive linemen, and 2 of them were all conference off this team last year. Their 2 starting wide receivers and their quarterback. And the defense has just carried this team along with their special teams. But it's the defense that has to come up with something right here to try and get one more chance.
Short of his first down.
The bad news is for Florida State is he went out of bounds and stopped the clock.
Yep. At 1:45 to play in the game. Each team with a timeout remaining.
Virginia was blitzing the free safety up the middle, so the line was slanting to the outside and forced him out of bounds.
Here's where Sean Liss wants an ugly punt.
He just wants it in the end zone. You don't want to give the punt returner a chance.
High knuckleball. Forcing the fair catch at the 19-20 yard line. Didn't get it as deep as you wanted. Tiki Barber handled the catch all right. And so here are the Cavaliers, 80 yards away from the promised land. Trailing by 7, 31-24, one timeout, and a minute and 37 seconds remaining.
We've got the number two defense in the country for Florida State.
Vernon Crawford, however, just came off the field, starting linebacker.
The guys that can make the plays for Virginia are Tiki Barber and Crowell.
Pressure chasing him, and he was on the run, throwing the ball out of bounds, incomplete. Peter Boulware was coming up his back, and Leonard Wilson was coming from the other direction.
Wilson was coming from one side, Boulware from the other. Wilson used to wrestle alligators as he was growing up. Remember, he caught one, he threw it in the pond in his dad's farm, and his mother didn't like it in the pond because she wanted the fish, so he went in and got the alligator out. He said, "Where do you want it?"
She said, "Out of town."
"Well, anywhere but in my pond."
Second down and 10. Sherman needs to get rid of it. He does, and it's downfield over everybody's head. It is incomplete. And Sherman is buried. To play in the game in a dogfight, 31-24, Florida State leading. Virginia led at halftime, 17-14. The Virginia offense, though, only flared up briefly and momentarily here in the fourth quarter when they went quickly downfield and got a quick touchdown to make it a 7-point ball game. But they have hung in, and they have a chance. Sherman puts it high in the air. The ball is slapped away. An incomplete forward pass. Samari Rowe goes up and knocks it down. It is fourth and 10 for Virginia.
So Virginia just won't go away. Mickey Andrews, the defensive coordinator,
next. Florida State, it goes to Georgia Tech next weekend. Fourth down. The last gasp is here. Sherman's pass is intercepted by James Colsey. And be careful, they're going to get a flag here. There's a Florida State man down the field, but he's all right apparently. Getting up slowly. Now there's your flag. They're going to get him for celebrating. This will be the second time in a ball game they've done it. A minute 10 to play in the game now, and Florida State will own the football. That's Greg Spires being helped off the field for Florida State. And they'll miss him because he's a big backup lineman who's played a lot today.
Well, it's fourth down, and as a quarterback, you see you got nothing left in the pocket, so just get out and let somebody get open. Cozy cuts in front of the receiver. That's a great play by a fourth-year senior. James Colsey got the start today. Owen coming across the field. Colsey looks back. He sees it. Tries to spread out. Nice play on the ball.
And so the penalty puts the football back at the 44-yard line of Virginia, where the Seminoles have it first down. And George pushes the cap back. They should spend it right about here if they choose to. The clock is running now, coming up on a minute to play. And as we pull back, this big crowd will start to move out of the stadium. And they've had a good time. It's been a good football game.
It has been a great game, Keith. And as far as one-dimensional as UVA's offense is, and that is Tiki Barber, They don't have much of a passing game. For as one-dimensional that it is, this game was awfully close. 24 points were scored. And like we've been saying, their defense contributes, sets them up with good field position, and so does their special teams.
So the Seminoles ranked number 3 in one poll, number 2 in another poll, and they will continue undefeated. The Virginia Cavaliers will be losing their second game of the season, but this is a pretty good football team that lives in Charlottesville. Clock stops now at 25 seconds.
They will always be known as a team that beat the first one to beat Florida State in the ACC. Game last year in Charlottesville, and they did not disgrace themselves here today.
Well, the string is going to continue that Bobby Bowden, since he came to Florida State, has never lost a homecoming game, and he still hasn't. He has become a legend since he came down to Tallahassee from Morgantown, West Virginia. He grew up just a stone's throw from Legion Field in Birmingham, Woodlawn High School, and then he went off to Howard University, or Samford, which it became eventually, and there was where he first coached. After he had been at South Georgia College in Douglas, he said he was coaching everything, including basketball, and he was so bad in basketball, they had to fire him, so. But he has become a wonderful, warm personality in the coaching profession and produced a lot of great football.
And he is great for college football. He is one of the bright and shining spotlights for college football.
And for George Welch, of course, he has his own place, and it's certainly strong. So here's your final score from Tallahassee. Florida State 31, Virginia 24, and here's John Saunders.
Keith, Texas trying to march in and grab the lead over Colorado. James Brown is back to pass, looks one way, pumps it, and is picked off by Steve Rosga, and that will just about seal the victory. About a minute and a half to go, 28-24, Colorado. Keith.
Virginia, that in itself is quite startling. But let me remind you, tomorrow, well, let's first look at the ACC standings. You see Florida State's now 5-0. Virginia drops to 4-2. North Carolina's in a non-conference game tonight. They are 4-1. But the Atlantic Coast Conference, if you're coming this way, bring your hard hat. They're pretty tough. Tomorrow, don't miss final round coverage of the Tour Championship. Tom Lehman, 13-under, leads the field tomorrow at 3 Eastern on ABC Sports.
This has been a presentation of...
That's more. Now, here's our other fullback, Khalid Abdullah, making a nice run up there. Our offensive line is doing a great job in there, and there's old... Well, Messam's got a lot of desire there, Henny. Great desire.
His final homecoming game at Florida State.
Boy,
wanted to have a good one.
Boy, here's a nice throw. Golly, another nice catch by Cooper. All, you know, that was the first down. I think we had more third down conversions than we've had all year, didn't we, Gene? Had about 8 or something like that.
At one point, we were 7 out of 10 on third down.
7 out of 10 on third down conversions, and so that was good. Bentley kicks another extra point there, and a field goal, and... they used a fake punt there. I had a feeling they wasn't supposed to have done it just the way they responded on the other side. But that was a fourth and about a five. They faked a punt and didn't make nothing. Watch this run here by Rock Preston. I owe Rock Preston an apology. I told him after the game because I had just told the bit of section that put Dunn in the ball game. We finally got position. And Bill said, hey, 24 will do okay. And sure enough, makes a great run. Nice run by Walter Jones. There's old Todd Fordham leading the note. Look at your quarterback.
Busby's going to escort him.
Busby's a good team, man. He screened that gal, and Rock used him to get in the end zone. Bentley kicks another extra point. And you think that put us up by two, I believe.
Yeah, two touchdown lead.
They wouldn't quit, though. Look at them. Great catch.
And the double coverage.
Yeah, we're there. We got him covered, but they just outfight us for the ball. I think it's the thing Mickey Andrews gets the most upset right now with our secondary. They're not fighting for the ball. There's Tim Sherman. You know, his dad, I knew his dad played quarterback for Penn State when I was coaching up there. We nearly had an interception.
There's got to be, his heart's got to be thumping right now because he's a wide receivers coach, and Virginia's got a chance to tie this ball game.
They sure have. But boy, I think Colsey from Miami makes a big interception there. Great interception. Thank you, Colsey. That gets it. There's Chevin Smith against Samari Rowe, and Hamlet is the odd couple in that secondary, and the rest of them from Miami. But it was a great win for us, and I tell you what, my hat's off, Virginia. Boy, what kind of, they got as much class as any, George Welts and Virginia's got as much class as any football team I know.
Florida State wins by 7 at home, and a happy homecoming, a weekend celebration in Tallahassee, Florida. Coming up, we look ahead to a trip to Atlanta.
Hey, cookies.
Say, you know, I think our neighbor might like one, too.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Terrific.
Gut milk.
They say that practice makes perfect. So my team is always practicing and looking for ways to make themselves better. That's the way to taste victory. There's no place to find a better example of success than at Golden Flakes. They've been making snack food since 1923. So every time you pick up a bag of Golden Flakes, you know you're picking a winner. Golden Flakes, it's where you find the flavor.
At Columbia's hospitals, we know what counts in an emergency. It's knowing you can get comprehensive, immediate attention 24 hours a day from highly trained professionals with years of experience and with the advanced technology to quickly diagnose and treat your emergency skillfully, carefully, and compassionately. Because at the Columbia family of hospitals, we know what counts most in an emergency. You.
In 1971, we started with a small wood-preserving plant. The seed was planted. Since then, our number one goal has been to be the best. My daddy always said that if you're ripe, you're rotten. If you're green, you're growing. Great Southern Wood, still growing after 25 years.
Florida State beats Virginia and avenges last year's heartbreaking loss in Charlottesville. And, Coach, we look ahead to the Yellow Jackets of Georgia Tech. And you've been predicting all along this is going to be a big football game.
Yeah, because I keep remembering 1992 when they had us beat and we pulled the game out at the end. And this is a very solid Georgia Tech football team, a team that's lost only one ball game and a game they could have won just as easily. They beat Virginia, the team that we had to fight for 60 minutes Saturday.
Yeah, Georgia Tech's only blemish, 16-0, and the rain in Chapel Hill, North Carolina, good North Carolina team.
Yeah. It'll be a tremendous test for us.
Coach, I want to congratulate you on a string unblemished at homecoming. I know all the old grads and alums that attended powwow on Friday night and the big football game on Saturday, they just love coming to Tallahassee when you don't lose on homecoming.
Saw Edinburgh Richardson, saw Bobby Butler, saw Walter Carter, Billy Adams. I saw some guys I hadn't seen in a long time. Plus, John Madden was there.
Happy homecoming, Coach.
Thank you, buddy.
Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next week.
The Bobby Bowden Show has...